Do you want to run and play latest apps and games on your Android phone, but it's old and outdated? Then you're gonna learn how to fix it by the end of this video tutorial. Hey guys, DexTechPro here again. Some of the people have trouble with their Android phones. Running some apps or playing games on it is kind of like nerve-wracking, because either the phone's Android version becomes old and not supportive for installation of latest games, even apps, which is a software issue, or their phone is slow because of its hardware configuration such as CPU, RAM, GPU, storage, and so on. But these guys still need to have them installed on their Android phone to play and run. Here is an awesome solution comes up with the name of virtualization. You can have a virtual machine installed on your computer with Android system software and run those apps and games directly inside it without using Android phones. So I'm gonna introduce one of the niftiest one, which is NOX'S Player. NOX'S Player is an Android emulator that you can install it on your computer as a virtual machine and enjoy experiencing Android in your PC without having a cell phone. It emulates phone environment inside your personal computer, so you can make the most of it. Okay, let's go for it. First of all, we go to bignox.com. Simply click on download button and download it. Now click on NOX'S and install it. Wait for installation process. Click on start. It asks to log into the Google Play Store by putting your Gmail user and password. So I do it. That's it. We are in. One of the things that I really like about NOX'S is that the installation is very straightforward and quick. Just a few clicks and you're in. Alright guys, go to tools and hit settings. Scroll down till you reach about tablet. As you can see, the Android version that NOX'S provides is 7.1.2, which is very nifty comparing to the other emulators. Now it's time to install apps and games on it. So let's start from the app. Go to Tools, scroll left, click on Play Store. Let's search for Skype. Simply click on Install. Okay, let's test it. Click on Open. Click on Let's Go. Click on sign in or create, and eventually sign into your account. So far so cool. Another way of app installation is offline one. Means you already have the app saved on your PC and you don't need to download it from the Google Play. Here is the way. For instance, I already downloaded WhatsApp on my laptop and I'm gonna install it offline in NOX'S Player. You simply drag and drop it into NOX'S and NOX'S will install it automatically. You can install the app by holding down your mouse's left key for 1 second, then click on Install. Now the app is gone forever. You can export installed apps from this menu by clicking on Export APK. NOX'S starts to export the app and opens up the folder containing it, then you can move and archive it wherever you want in your computer for the further usage. Okay, now let's install game on it instead. Open up Google Play Store. Click on Game section. Let's go for an action game. Search for Ace Fighter. Simply click on Install. Let it install and finish. So let's play for a while. Open it up. You play games by mouse and keyboard here. You can also play with the controller or joystick. I click on Continue. Here I choose Control the Jet using touchscreen and I follow the instructions. Thank you. Guess you guys got the point. So you close the game by clicking on three dots on the right side of your screen and click on close all apps button. As you can see, the game's shortcut is placed here on dashboard and ready to be used from now on. You can also install games offline as well. In this case, I'm gonna export Ace Fighter, uninstall it, then install exported APK file back offline. Hold down left click on it for 1 second, then hit on export APK. Great! Now I remove it by the same way. Click on uninstall. It is gone. Get back to the exported game. Instead of dragging and dropping it into the NOX'S dashboard, I just double click on it. NOX'S automatically installs the game from Windows inside itself. That's called file association, which links APK files to NOX'S in this scenario. Alright, now you know how to install, uninstall, and run Android apps and games on your Windows computer. Let's check some of the features of NOX'S Player and get familiar with them in order to make the most of it. Click on this little gear icon and go to Settings. Check the box Root. Well, rooting is the process which gives Android users full privilege control, so to say root access, to overcome limitations that carriers and hardware manufacturers put on some devices. Click on Performance Settings. You see some settings related to performance such as numbers of CPU cores, amount of RAM, or graphics rendering mode like OpenGL or DirectX and screen resolution settings. We have interface settings and sound settings, which ain't a big deal, so I'm not gonna cover them. We have game settings, that you can set up the FPS or frame rate per second according to your computer hardware configuration. We have phone model and internet, in which you can select your virtual phone brand and model like Samsung, Asus, LG or Google. In clean and backup settings, you can clean up junk files which took up your storage size. You can also back up whole virtual machine with your customized settings and install apps, then import it back to restore all you had intact. And the last one is shortcut settings, which you can map different keys to different functions for your convenience. We also have some tools on the right side of your screen that you can use. For example, print screen that captures the screen and saves it as an image for you. Multi-drive. You can add multiple Android machines and run them in parallel by this function. Click on three dots, lower right of the window, and pick up the Android version of your virtual machine. For instance, Android 7. Now it's created and ready. Click on Start button. Now you have the second brand new Android 7 while you're running the first one in background. You can add and run multiple Android 5 or 7, but it depends on the computer hardware configuration and performance. You can delete it from here and set it up with different configuration by clicking on Settings gear button as well. There is a nifty function called Sync which synchronizes all running Android machines simultaneously. First, we need to run multiple Android machine by clicking on Multi-drive and play the second one that we already made. Click on three dots to expand the hidden tools where the sync is located, then click on Sync icon. Just click on play. Now everything you do in the first machine will be replicating in the second one. For example, I click on tools in first one, and it sends it to the second one as well. This is super handy when you want to configure multiple virtual machines at the same time. Then click on pause or stop whenever you're done with this. Now it's time for file sharing. What if you want to share or transfer files from computer to Android back and forth? Well, here's the way. I like to send an image from Windows to Android, so I browse my Windows folder to reach the image I want to share. I copy it in the clipboard and get back to the dashboard. Click on File Assist in toolbar. Click on Open PC folder. Browse the image share folder. And paste the picture here. Now, I can see this picture inside the Android by getting back to the File Assist window. And this time, I click on Open Android Folder. Scroll down to find Pictures folder. Open it up. And boom, that's our picture inside the Android. You can do file sharing in opposite way too. For example, I like to transfer the game I already installed from Android to Windows and then archive it for the further usage. So I select the game and export APK file from dashboard. Then containing folder of the exported game opens up automatically and the file is accessible from Windows environment now. Another function that I personally really like about NOX'S is macro. Well, technically a macro, which stands for macro instruction, is a programmable pattern which translates a certain sequence of input into a preset sequence of output. It simply means that it records every single of your actions and can repeat it for you. Then you don't need to repeat them again. It's an awesome function for automatization. Open up macro recorder. Now I'm trying to make some changes and see how macro works for us. Click on record button to start recording our actions. For example, click on tools, open gallery, then close it. Go to tools again. Open up Amaze file manager. Scroll down, go to download. Click on plus button. Make a new folder. Call it Dex. Select. Then delete it. Get back to the dashboard. Then click on stop button. The macro is created and we can run it by hitting on play button. As soon as I hit that play button, NOX starts to do whatever I did step by step. Let's play it. You see guys, it is doing exactly what I did. Great job. You can customize macro by hitting on this gear icon and change the number of loops, which means how many times you want this macro runs, or set up the acceleration, which changes how fast you want it to go on. And of course, you can delete it by hitting on this trash icon here. Come on guys, unleash the power of your computer by having an Android operating system install on it. Why not? And that's the end of this video tutorial guys. Hope you find it informative. Leave me comments, ask me questions. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet, 'cause new videos are on the way. Thanks for watching and have a good one.